Next surah is Surah An-Nas, and Nas means mankind. If you see the surah, Allah says, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. There are six surahs, six ayahs in this surah, and in five ayahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the word An-Nas. And Mufassirin have mentioned that each Nas means different. Each Nas, each word Nas has different meaning in this surah. For example, you see قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, then you see مَلِكِ النَّاسِ, إِلَهِ النَّاسِ, مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. The subject matter of the surah is the same as has been mentioned in Surah Al-Falaq, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to seek protection from Al-Falaq, from مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ. And قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. I seek refuge with Allah, the Lord of mankind, the King of mankind, the Ilah of mankind, from the evil of the whisperer, Al-Khannas, who withdraws after whispering. الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ, who whispers in the breast of mankind, of jinn and men, min al-jinnati wal-nas. Mufassirin have mentioned that the first word nas, which has been mentioned in the first ayah, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, here it means children. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, I seek refuge with Allah, the Lord of mankind, or the Lord of nas. And the word nas here refers children. That's why Allah mentions Rabb, which gives the meaning of bringing up. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes care of those children that they cannot protect themselves at that time. And you will see them how they suffer when they lose their parents. So how important their upbringing is in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you also understand. The next ayah in the surah Malikin Nas, in this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the king of mankind, but here the word Nas refers to the youth. And the youth, especially those youth who are working for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are in the path of Allah, they are fighting for His cause, and they are spreading the message of Allah, trying to guide people on the right path. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is their king. They are working, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with them. And ilahin nas, the ilah of mankind. And here, an-nas refers to the older people. You know, when people grow older, they give more time to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they try to stay away from worldly things. So Allah, at that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is closer to them, or they are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they devote their maximum time to Allah. And also there is a lesson from this verse that they should not worry about this worldly life. They should completely at that time turn themselves towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they must devote their time in His worship. مِن شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ, from the evil of the whisperer, Al-Khannas, who withdraws from his whispering in one's heart after one remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas, who whispers in the breast of mankind. And here, An-Nas refers to Ahlul Islah wa Taqwa, people of taqwa, people of piety, who have piousness in their heart, people who have fear of Allah in their hearts. So the word An-Nas here refers to them. And it is because shaitan always runs after them. They have fear of Allah, so they try everything against shaitan, and shaitan is their enemy. So it is these people about whom shaitan always try to deviate them from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas, so these shayateen always whisper in the breast of mankind, but especially people of taqwa. من الجنة والناس and of jinn and mankind. So these people who whisper in the hearts of people and they play magic upon people or they deviate them from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these they can be from the jinn and from the nas, from human beings. So if you see that there is a devil, so that can as well as from human beings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them. This is the end of Surah An-Nas. We have, due to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and due to his blessings, we have finished the glorious Quran in Tafsir today. Inshallah, after this, Dr. Khalid Siddiq will come and will explain to you about the program of Tafsir which has been going on here. I have been doing it for the last 3 years, and I finished last 7 juz since I started doing it. There were many people who were doing it, and especially I would like to mention the name of Dr. Nazir Warsi, Dr. Hisham Hawasli, Brother Abdul Rahim, and they have been main parts of this program. So inshallah he will tell you about this program and how beneficial it is for us and for all of human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran in our life to guide us on the right path. It is a guidance for us, but my brothers and sisters, when we look at ourselves, how much time we give to the glorious Quran. It is a responsibility upon us, but we do not fulfill it. How many of us are able to recite the Quran? You can imagine. How many of us are able to understand the meaning of the glorious Quran? This is a time we should regret, and also we should be happy that at least we have tried whatever we can do. When I was doing it, maybe intentionally or unintentionally, knowingly or unknowingly, if something happens from me, I utter words or anything happens, I seek first of all forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I explain something wrong unintentionally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive me and forgive all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the love of the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the good understanding of the glorious Quran. But my last request will be to everybody that give some time to the glorious Quran. It is an obligation upon you and upon every human being. This is the message of Allah through which you reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You recite the glorious Quran, try to understand the meaning of the glorious Quran, and inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open your heart, will open your brain, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep you on the right path. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Inshallah, now I request Dr. Khalid Siddiq, he will come inshallah, and he will talk about this program, inshallah.